Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Nexus Testing. Today we will be testing out a deck that a friend recommended to me. And as a fan of the Zexal anime, I thought maybe it would be interesting to try out this instead of something like a more meta-defined deck at the moment, or one of the newer supports in Lightning Overdrive. I will be getting a box of that and recording it, hopefully. But today we're going to be testing out his deck list and showing off what a Gimmick Puppet deck can do. Of course, I did a lot of reading and testing off screen to try and get used to the cards, so I will admit I'm still not a perfect pilot, and I don't think I will be, because I'm just mainly seeing what a beginner can do with all these decks. Remember, at the end of the day, the series is to show somebody who is getting into a deck they don't really know that well, and seeing if they can get better at it through maybe one or two games. That doesn't mean every deck is bad. If I can't do that, remember that. So, for this list, we have 3 Bistall, which is a special summon by discarding a Gimmick Puppet, which a lot of Gimmick Puppets love being in the graveyard, so she really helps you fill up the grave. And you can banish it to make it so all of your Gimmick Puppets become untargetable, which is, well, it's not on par with Misk, but there's a card later, Misk and Dinosaurs, but there's a card later that I believe would be considered on par with them. Dreary Doll as a special summon from the grave by banishing another Gimmick Puppet, and then it's just a special summon from the grave by banishing another Gimmick Puppet. 3 of Humpty Dumpty, when this is just get out another Gimmick Puppet if you have a bunch in hand. We have 3 Terror Baby, which allows you to normal summon it, and then you get another special summon from the graveyard. And then if you banish it, your opponent cannot activate cards or effects in response to the Gimmick Puppets you control, which, let's be honest, that is the Misk effect I was talking about. 3 of those. 3 Gimmick Puppet Magnet Doll, which is a bit restrictive, but with how this deck plays, you kinda can get the restrictiveness off pretty well. Your opponent controls monster, and you control all face-up Gimmick Puppets, special summon it. 2, Mecha Phantom Beast Tether Wolf, which sounds odd, because they're slightly xenophobic, but if you normal summon this and get its token, you can go into the link. We have Gear Spring Spirit, which is another level 8 Dark Machine, which can be special summoned by having machines in your graveyard, which a lot of the times you do. And it allows you to just decrease a monster your opponent controls to 0 if you want to try and go for an OTK. 3 Trade In, which is you use for any deck that uses level 8s. Hopefully you'll see me use this in my Ogdatic deck if I ever get around to making it. Machine Dupe, because we have 2 targets. Yeah, 2 targets for it. Rake Up Magic Quick Chaos, because you want to go into the chaos numbers. Blah. A lot. We have Numeron Force, which is another version of Quick Chaos, but this one negates the effects of all other face-up other cards and monsters. So you get a blanket negate on top of getting a bigger monster. Argent Chaos Force, which I think it's another form of chaotic summoning. Exceed summoning? Yes, it is. Sorry. I'm still getting used to the Chaos Exceed summoning. 2 Junk Puppet as a way to recur any Gimmick Puppets that are still in the graveyard that haven't been banished for their effects or via other means. Condolence Puppet, which if you're going against a deck that's heavy on the extra deck, you can get a bunch of Gimmick Puppets from your deck onto the field, and then you can banish it and make it so it's base. It's unaffected by, not unaffected, but cannot be destroyed by your opponent's card effects. And this is any machine, so you can use it to protect your Zeus. Perform Puppet, to make all your monsters you control currently level 8, which isn't terrible, which is not bad because you want to go into rank 8s, but it's not heavily needed to be played at 3. And if it gets if a gimmick puppet you control is destroyed, you get one of your banished gimmick puppets back. Puppet Parade, which is this one lets you Foolish Burial, and this is the one that allows you to get a bunch of gimmick puppets out from the deck, because If your opponent controls more monsters than you, and if you're going first or second with Puppet Parade, you can go into plenty of Xyz. 3, Infinite Impermanence as just a way of hand traps. And 2, Trap Trick, because you're running 2 normal traps. Then we have 2 of Chimera Doll, their Link, which is honestly really good for the deck, because not only do you get a Foolish Burial or a Search, you can, if you control a Gimmick Puppet, you can special summon one from your hand after the effect's gone off. 2, Gimmick Puppet of Strings, to get those string counters and destroy them during the end phase. Then Dark Strings, for after you use its effect to give all your opponent monster string counters, use Ardent Quick Chaos to go into this to destroy them all. We have Gimmick Puppet of Leo. I haven't gone into this a lot, but I believe it's still a good enough card. Though it does not have built-in protection, the way it protects itself through its other cards, I think is good enough to maybe get off the win con. Same with its Chaos version. 2, Gimmick Puppet Giant Grinder, which if you're going to get it to the Xyz deck, is, I wouldn't say it's a blowout, but holy moly, it is good against the Xyz decks. And then numbers Chaos form to just go into more burn damage. Gigantis Doll to go to take control of your opponent's monsters, and this is perfect for your Humpy Dumpy and Terror Baby. And if you tribute it, all monsters you control become level 8, so after you take monsters with Gigantis Doll, make them all level 8 to go into your Xyz. Adingirsu is a dark machine, and it's just a good rank 8 overall. Babuska, if we really have already used our Gigantis Doll and we're in a losing position, you can make this almost any other good rank 4 if you ever so want. And then Zeus, because we're running an Xyz deck and it's a machine, so it can be protected off of Condolence Puppet. So let's get into games, and hopefully we're not going against Sweat Lords. Of course, like I said, I don't know that much about this deck other than what I've read. Trying to get better at it testing. Oh boy. Hold on. Yeah, I've had this issue a lot with Nexus where it's just. Where it wants to. Stop it. My computer is not that good. Sorry, folks. So we're going to switch to Europe. And hopefully. This game goes better than we want. I believe our main goal is to go first because it. Buddy, please, I just want to play the game. Buddy, alright, there we go. I think our main goal is to go first, but a going second build is not, going second is not terrible. Let's see what we're up against, hopefully it, okay, Terra. Fire King, interesting, okay. My question is this, is it Fire, would it be Fire King? Yeah. Wait. Oh yeah, Fire King. What's its effect if you special summon this card? If this card is destroyed, send from each I mean, there's no need to Infinite Impermanence, I don't believe. In your hand, I don't really need to because I've never gone against Fire Kings other than I know Garunix is one of my favorite artworks of all time. Huh. Alright, let's see what we can do from here. We're going to normal summon Humpty Dumpty. And then we'll activate its effect, special summon a Terror Baby. And because we can't really go into Gigantes at the moment, I think the best here would be go into... I think Chimera Doll instead of Babuska and see if we can build a board. Activate it and to go into... We'll send... do I want to send Dreary Doll? I want to get a level 4. I think best would be... send Dreary Doll. And then special summon the Terror Baby. Oh, I feel bad. Well, we technically won that game. I wouldn't say we won one, but we won. alright, let's go, buddy. Oh no. Ah, okay. Okay, they're going first. Let's see. Oh, T-Set. I feel bad. I'm about to end this whole man's career. No, I'm not. But let's go with a Terror Baby. We'll go into not that Machine Dupe. Get our other Terror Babies from the deck. I believe Gigantes is face up only. Let's see. Oh. Ooh, we're going against a god. Oh no. We fed him very well. I am sad. Ah, that's infuriating. Alright. And because we're already normal. Fuck. Okay. Oops, sorry, I didn't mean to say that. I think we can still play, actually. Hold on. We'll go into this. Activate Dreary Doll by banishing one of our Terror Babies. And then we'll banish another Terror Baby so that we cannot be activated in response. We'll go into Strings, I think would be the best play here. It may have been better to go into the Link, I'm not certain. We'll get over his Raw. Main Phase 2. There's no need to activate Strings effect, but we can go into Zeus. Though it won't have the most charges, it still is a good... Ah, I should have summoned a defense. Oh well. It's still a good card to go to. We'll go into the end phase. Hopefully they're not an actual, like, anime protagonist that can go into any card they want. Wow. I'm going to activate Zeus. Detach. And we'll get rid of that. Oh, Sabers. Okay, I think this man literally is trying to build the deck off the structure decks. Sad. But respectable. We'll go into the Link with the Mega Phantom Beast and its token. I think the best suit would be to summon... I think you want to send Dreary Doll. Sadly, we can't get anything off of that, but we'll activate its effect. We'll banish Terror Baby. Special summon Dreary Doll, then use Junk Puppet to get the other Dreary Doll. We'll go into our last Strings. And we'll just... Not for BM, we're mainly just making sure that we have game. And then we'll attack for game. There we go. Alright. Thank you, Vood. Sorry. I feel bad. But there we go. That spell card he used where he can tribute all monsters on your opponent's turn, that's actually quite interesting. I didn't read that far ahead into the Egyptian god support, but that's interesting. Oh, no! Oh, no! I hope it's him again. I don't want to do that to him. Hopefully this time we get a different person. There we go. Hello, Golden Metal. Me against you. Heck. Okay. Alright, they're going first. We do have... Oh, are we going against, I wonder if we're going against a more modern hero deck, or if we're going against Flamewing Man Turbo, because, Stratos doesn't really help. We get Stratos, go into Ferris, if I remember. Yep. So we do have full hero combo. Yep, so we're just gonna send Mally, he's gonna sit Vion, Vion's effect to special summon itself by tributing over Ferris. To get the increase, then go into Vion. Apologies. I kind of just built here, deconstructed my IRL heroes and sold all the more expensive cards. But I remember the combo pretty much. They get a Foolish to get Shadow Mist. They get Liquid Soldier, a card I did not have because I think it is still very expensive because Konami does not want people to actually play heroes. They go into Cross Crusader, Mally to Special Summon, Tribute it to get... Is it a search? I think it was a search. Yeah. A Search of Honest Neos. Honest Neos will be annoying, but I believe that we can still play through it. The main thing we want here, though, is we need to get into strings. If we at least get into strings, they'll go into Sunrise to get a Miracle Fusion, get the draw 2 off of the Liquid Soldier. Sending Shadow Mist again, because I don't think this is optimal. There has to be more. Okay, there's the mass change for, I would think, Dark Law. Yeah, Dark Law. Dark Law, so they get a one-sided macro. They go into Dread. Oh, Wonder Driver. Activate the Miracle Fusion. They go into Absolute Zero. Wonder Driver's effect. Did the mass change. And then they're able to set mass change, and then they'll be able to nuke us on our turn. Ah, boy. Okay. We're not going to be able to do much on this, basically what I'm seeing, but we'll send. I forgot, it's not on field, it's all around. Ugh. We at least get Terror Baby. I'm not happy. They're going to be able to activate the mass change to pop, to get rid of their Absolute Zero to go into, what's it called? The mass water hero. I don't think there's much we can do here. Yeah, I think we may have just lost this all because of that big combo. They're gonna be able to OTK on this turn. Yeah, they're gonna get the Absolute Zero to go into the, I think it's liquid? Yeah, acid, sorry. And because this is during my end phase, I can't activate Puppet Parade, and so this will be able to clear all the back row. Yep, I think we're just going to have to concede. We'll try to go into one more duel for this game, this video, but holy moly. I think it is better to go first with Gimmick Puppets, but it's not impossible to go second, especially if you're going to Big Beater. I'm not going against you again, brother. I'm sorry. Alright, CPDDPC. I want a duel, not the Among Us code. Is that still funny? Am I still comedy? Go first. Alright, wow, I don't know if this is a good hand. This is annoying. I can at least go into Busca, which I genuinely think is the only good play I have. We're gonna do just that. Activate Humpty Dumpty, special summon the Terror Baby, go into Beguska, and then cry because I feel like I'm a meanie because, if you cannot, why'd I summon it into defense? I'm stupid. Oh no, it is in defense. Okay. I'm sorry. I was reading its first effects of attack position. Alright. All this character is in face-up defense. Change all face-up monsters. Okay. Cyber Dart. Ooh, they're going to be playing the Cyber Style deck. Interesting. I don't know if they need their effects, but hopefully we learn that through this game. Change all face, also negate the infinite effects. Okay. Okay, during your stand. But okay, let's see if we are royally fucked because of the Cyber Darks or. Okay, yeah. Okay, they switch to defense on summon. Then they don't get their effects. Can they at least target? They can. I think they can. We're going to attach Humpty Dumpty. I don't think we'll be able to activate the Terror Wolf effect because... is there anything? If I switch it to attack position, I'll be able to go into what I want, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to OTK. I think we should just go for it. We'll go for Mecha Phantom Beast. Activate its effect, unless they have a response. I've never really read. I saw the 10-minute testing for Cyber Darks, but let's see. That's a dark. It's not. That's a dark. Okay. Oh. Okay. Set. We have Sad Boy Hours. Apologies. My neighbor thinks he's cool. I can't attack. Sad. Sag. We're gonna go into the end phase. Oh boy. Oh boy. Crush card. It's weird seeing Crush card actually played in this format, but... Okay. Cyber and Dragon. Mike Event Beast. Sorry, I'm just reading over what I can probably do my next turn. We'll send Infant. We're not able to special summon this, and I don't think, we're not going to be able to go into that. Baby wouldn't be helpful, so all we can really do is end here and hope we don't get destroyed on the crackback. We at least have one more defensive wall with the token, and I think if they summon another monster, we may be able to do something, but I'm currently not holding my breath. One more dragon. What did they send? They sent... Oh, Buster Sword. Oh, they're gonna lock me. Is there a way to lock that? No, I remember. Okay. There is a way, but it's... Okay. We're gonna Infinite Impermanence your edge, because that's funny. I'm not gonna activate this now. I'm just gonna let them go in for the damage. I think that would be the worst case scenario. We're gonna... Actually, if I let them... Yeah. No, we're going to let them destroy the token, and I'll take that 2400. And then on the end phase, we'll activate Puppet Parade. Or I can chain it to this. Overload Fusion, Mother Trucker. That's actually good for me, I believe, though, because then I'd get another Gimmick Puppet. We'll have to wait and see what happens. So they'll go into they'll send two Cyber Ends. I see what they're doing. That's actually kind of interesting in a way. But I think we can play. I think I know what I can do here. I just got to get over Cyber Dark End Dragon, which is not entirely impossible. Just hard, so I want to get a Dreary Doll, a Magnet Doll, and a Biss Doll. I think, is this protected? Okay, if we go into Dingirsu, I think we can send this off of the Ding. Let's just wait and see what happens. We can equip one watch on the graveyard. We'll just equip an attack up numbered. Okay. Though I am a fan of Big Beat you. There's nothing I can do. No! I literally cannot play now! Oh, no! That's what they were going for with Cyber Dark End! Oh, no! Oh, that's painful. I can get a dreary doll. Oh no. Oh boy. I'm mad, but I'm not, because that's genius. Oh boy. There's not much I can do. Oh boy, yeah, I think I may just concede. Yeah, I'm looking at it, there's no way I can easily get rid of that. But thank you for watching. It's not a horrible deck, I really want to believe it's not. It is in the right hands. But oh my god, a extra deck lock, most like a bunch of decks, just is very not fun. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you all in the next video. This has been Skulls.